Hey, what's up, guys? Hope everybody's doing well and having a great day. In this video, we're going to visit the Yellowstone Super Volcano. I want to talk about an article I read 5 years ago over here at livescience.com, dated May 2nd of 2016. They talk about some things to look for prior to a potential volcanic eruption over at the Super Volcano. And the information in this article is from scientists at the USGS Yellowstone Volcano Observatory. And one of the main talking points is obviously the ash plume, how it would reach the east coast of the United States in some capacity. Probably not super thick, you know, you're talking less than an inch. But around the caldera, you're looking at quite possibly 3 feet in some areas, extending all the way to Chicago, where they could see an inch, maybe an inch and a half. And this is all potential, depends on how big the eruption would be. According to the article, the last three eruptions known were 2.1 million years ago, 1.3 million years ago, and 640,000 years ago. You, like me, have always heard that it's overdue, it's due for an eruption, but at the end of the day, nobody really knows. But I will say in this article, and it's a good article, you can find link below in the description box if you want to read it in its entirety. I want to read a section out of this article that does pertain to some things we're seeing today. And basically what they're talking about is things to look out for prior to a possible eruption. Again, not guaranteed, but these were things that were talked about 5 years ago, and we're starting to see some of these things today. I've been following the seismographs at the caldera over here at Yellowstone for many, many years, and you can see what it looks like today. Looks very busy because we're in the middle of an ongoing swarm right here in the middle of Yellowstone Lake. In fact, I'll show you the swarm right here at the USGS map. You can see there are dozens of earthquakes varying from 3.6 all the way down to a 1. And each one of these earthquakes has a different depth, anywhere from 5 miles to less than a mile. The seismographs, they look like they are working overtime. All of these red vertical lines are earthquake signatures. If we click on one, let's say Lake Butte, this is over here on the east side of Yellowstone Lake. Look at all of the earthquake signatures. Dozens, probably over 100, quite possibly 200. I remember a time many years ago. In fact, I'll take you back to that time. We'll just pick a random time back, say 10, 15 years ago. If you go up here in the upper left-hand corner of this website, and this is a site that I've used for years that show the seismographs at the supervolcano caldera. You can go back in time. Click on this little tab right here where it says month, day, and year. Let's go back to, say, 2007. Then click Generate Report. The graphs looked a little different. There weren't quite as many graphs as you see today, but look how clean they are. Very little activity on these graphs. This is July 17th of 2007. We can go back even further. We can go back to 2005. Click Generate Report. And once again, see how quiet they are? And I know you guys have heard me say, I can remember a time coming over here, and when you'd see a little blip on the graph, you would think something was going on, because there was very little activity detected on these seismographs at the supervolcano caldera. Let's go back up to 2021. Look at the graphs and you can see the obvious difference. Yes, granted, we're in the middle of an earthquake swarm right in the middle of Yellowstone Lake, but this activity has slowly but surely been increasing over the years, and I've noticed that slow but steady change because I've been coming over here for many, many years, like a lot of people. But let's go back to the article here at livescience.com, and it goes on to say, watch out for little eruptions. As with magma mapping, the science of forecasting volcanic eruptions is always improving. Most scientists think that magma buildup would be detectable for weeks, maybe years, preceding a major Yellowstone eruption. Warning signs would include distinctive earthquake swarms, gas emissions, and rapid ground deformation. Someone who knows about these warning signals might look at the park today and think, whoa, something weird is going on. Yellowstone is a living volcano, and there are always small earthquakes causing tremors and gas seeping from the ground. Keep in mind, this article was written back in 2016, and the graphs over here did not look like this back in 2016. In fact, I'll show you what they look like. Keep in mind, the volcano even breathes. The ground surface swells and sinks and gases and fluids move around the volcanic plumbing system beneath the park. But the day-to-day shaking in the park does not portend doom. The Yellowstone Volcano Observatory has never seen warning signs of an impending eruption at the park, according to the USGS. What are scientists looking for? For one, the distinctive earthquakes triggered by moving molten rock. Magma tunneling underground sets off seismic signals that are different from those generated by slipping fault lines. We would see earthquakes moving in a pattern and getting shallower and shallower. And that's another thing that we've noticed here recently. You're looking at the earthquakes around the supervolcano in the last 30 days over here at the USGS. This is as far back as we can go. And you can see, depending on what your definition of a swarm is, at least three obvious swarms. The one that's ongoing right now, there was one here about 2 weeks ago, and another one about a month ago. These are three definite swarms. All of the quakes are different magnitudes. Over here in the ongoing swarm, the strongest is a 3.6, I think, that occurred in the last 12 hours. But they are getting shallow. Look at that one right there, 0.0 kilometers. That was a surface earthquake coming in at 2.0 magnitude. Here's one that's 1.8 kilometers, 2.0. That's around a mile deep. Here's another one, 1.9 kilometers, 1.8 in strength. Some of them are 5.6 kilometers, a kilometer there. That's below a mile. That's less than a mile deep at 2.4 magnitude. All of these earthquakes are different. I don't think there's any two on here that are the same. This particular map over the last 30 days shows 617 earthquakes around the supervolcano and near the caldera. And that's one of the things the scientists said back in 2016, May of 2016. One of the things to watch out for would be an increase in earthquake swarms and a decrease in the depth of the earthquakes that accompany some of these earthquake swarms. And again, we've seen three swarms now in the last 30 days. Looking at some of the other local seismographs in the area, one over here at Flag Ranch. Flag Ranch is right here, south and slightly west of Yellowstone Lake. And you can see it's been doing some sort of acrobatics in the past several weeks. In fact, I think it's been like this for months. You'll see the lines on the seismograph go at a slant, sometimes slanting up and sometimes slanting down. That's not normal. Usually the lines are straight across and you might see an earthquake signature show up on the lines. You can see some unusual activity here in Dillon, Montana. That's not far from the supervolcano. More unusual activity over here at Fox Creek. You can see it looks like the ground is kind of wavy there at that particular time. That's an earthquake signature, classic earthquake signature, and a lot of small earthquakes on this particular seismograph. Fox Creek is located just north and slightly east of the Yellowstone Lake, where the ongoing swarm is occurring right now as I do this video. So I just wanted to share that article with you guys. I remember reading this years ago, goes back to 2016, and what the experts mentioned in this article about what would happen if Yellowstone supervolcano erupted and what would happen prior to the volcanic eruption. You would see a change in earthquakes, earthquake patterns, and earthquake depths. And we're definitely seeing that right now. Does that mean that that's going to guarantee a volcanic eruption anytime soon? Absolutely not. Nobody knows when this volcano is going to erupt again, if it's going to erupt again. It could go on like this for another 500 years. We don't know. This is all uncharted territory because we haven't been monitoring the caldera for that long. Considerably speaking, the last time the volcano erupted was 640,000 years ago. There wasn't anybody here 640,000 years ago that I know of that was monitoring the supervolcano. So all of this data that we're trying to interpret here is all fairly new, considerably speaking. So is it going to erupt anytime soon? I wouldn't think so. I'm just relaying what the experts said in an article back on May 2nd of 2016. And you can find this article linked below in the description box. Thanks for watching. Have a super day and be safe out there.